But one of the first things I want to tap into is a line that I heard you doing your piece, which was, our muscle memory makes miracles. Mm-hmm. What would you say to the poet? What habit would you tell the poet, the future poet, to really embody and hold on to in order for him to make history the same way you did?
Mm. Well, first off, thank you. That means a lot to, you know, coming from you, and it's a blessing to represent all the poets, be a part of this. It's a beautiful family that we're a part of, and it's something I don't take lightly or take for granted. And me, I was passed the baton. We were all passed the baton.
Right.
I always felt like it was our responsibility to keep it moving. For those future poets or those poets that are coming up, like what I would encourage is just to write. Just write. I got a poem called I Need to Write. And the more that I wrote, the more that I saw my pen grow, the stories grow, the further I went, you know, I started to dig even deeper and start to like really listen. Like I feel like our superpower as poets, as storytellers, is the ability to listen. So when I write, I'm really like, it's really almost like a meditation. You know, I quiet myself, I breathe deep, and I listen. So when I woke up a few days ago, that line, our muscle memory is made up of miracles, popped into my head. I'm like, yo, I need to write that down. Mm-hmm. So if that's one part of it, is like, don't wait. Like if something hits you, like write it down. Like write it down. Use your phone. Do whatever you need to do.
Yeah.
And then be fearless with it. Like a lot of people would, you know, get caught up in what would he say, she say, and what would they think. Mm-hmm. Like you gotta just like get the fear like completely out of your psyche and just remember, if you feel it, other people will feel it. Like for me, like when you talk about remarkable moments, like what's a remarkable moment that stands out? I did a piece, I narrated Beyonce's Black is King promo, which was the return, like the return in the NBA. And it's like with the queen.
That was hard, bro.
You know, but when I reflect back on Never Let Me Down, one of the most amazing parts of that is seeing a kid who wasn't even born when I recorded it, wasn't born when the album came out, and they had sent me a video of them performing it, word for word. And that is, it's like my God, like, you know, thank you, like, I can't believe it. It's fuel and energy to keep going. It's like, okay, if I was able to do that, what else can I do? What other marks can I make? Because I've always been, I guess, fixated with making history. I'm like, God gave me something special during this time, like the time that we living in gave us a voice.
Yeah.
And we know the importance of our stories and the importance of like the impact those stories can have. So I'm always like, okay, how can I touch your soul, right? So to flip the script and have somebody reciting a piece, I've seen it, kids performing at their graduation.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's—
it's one of those,
incredible.
Dog.
Incredible, man. It's a, like, it's yeah, it's love, man.
And one of the last things I want to ask you is that, you know, when you think about your journey, when you think about the pieces you've made and your the piece you'll have in history, do you think you left your mark already, or do you think that, you know, your mark is still yet to come?
I'm gonna take it back to what I said earlier about, you know, our superpowers is our ability to listen, and when I listen to my spirit, I know I've been able to do some incredible things, and I've been able to make some historic marks. But my spirit tells me there's so much more to do. A lot of times I forget about those moments until times like this, and we start talking and going back down memory lane, because I'm really just focus on the spirit, and spirit is like, yo, it like there's more to do. Like right now in this moment, There's somebody that hasn't heard you. There's somebody who hasn't impacted you. There's some healing that can happen through your voice and your storytelling. So, have I made my mark? Yes, but I know that there are many more marks to make. So I'm looking forward. And then I would also say it's super important to surround yourself with greatness. Like, you know, we're not on an island. We don't do this alone. Like, I was always inspired by all these incredible, dynamic poets, singers, MCs, comedians, actors, dancers, just thought leaders. Mm-hmm. So it's important that you surround yourself with that, surround yourself with love, and then pour that into your art so, you know, you can stand next to them proud.
Yeah.
And we can all share in moving our culture forward. So that's what I'm aiming at.
That's love.
Yeah.
From the heart, man. We gonna distance that.
What's up?
Yeah,
what's up?
Man.
No doubt.